This video introduces what the SAMR model is and how this model can provide a framework for one-to-one learning with mobile devices. SAMR is a model created by Dr. Ruben Pandidura, aiming to provide a technology integration model for educators. With the emerging trend on one-to-one learning with mobile devices, this model has become very popular in recent years. SAMR stands for Substitution, Augmentation, Modification, and Redefinition. This is an excellent framework guiding educators providing meaningful technology integration, not just using tools for the sake of using tools. Substitution refers to replacing paper-based activities with a digital tool without functional change. For example, looking up online atlas or dictionary to replace the actual paper atlas or dictionary. Augmentation refers to direct substitution with functional improvement. For example, the Microsoft Office program can point out spelling or basic grammar problems as one type. Modification refers to using technology for significant task redesign. For example, learners can collaborate online via wiki or social media. They can see each other's work and provide peer comments. It's easier to communicate with partners via learning management systems. Google Drive is a good tool for various examples for modification. Redefinition allows for the creation of new tasks that cannot be done without the technology. For example, students can post their work online and invite experts or everyone in the community to comment. VoiceThread is a good example. Students can put their projects online and invite parents or community members to provide feedback. Technology integration can take place at all levels. Depending on the learning tasks, we may start at a substitution or modification levels. The end goal is to have some activities that are at the modification or redefinition levels. Here's an excellent flowchart to help educators in determining the tasks they are qualified for each SAMR level. First, think about if your technology activity can be completed by analog or non-tech means. If yes, this is a substitution activity. For example, looking up a city capital on online atlas versus paper atlas. If the answer is no, think about if the learning task is to bring transformational learning opportunities. If the answer is yes, it's very likely a redefinition activity. If no, it's augmentation in which it is a slight enhancement of substitution task. You can develop the task further to include online collaboration with experts, share work online, and receive feedback. If the answer is partially yes, the activity is a modification level task, and it most likely involves integration of multiple applications. For example, the activity could involve online collaboration with peers and experts, such as in the case of entering an international competition to complete a project-based learning plan. Now let's take a look at the examples of a transformative learning activity at a redefinition level. The activities could provide opportunities for online collaboration, expert feedback, innovative use of technology, and inter-school collaboration. For example, school along the Mississippi River can share water testing results and photo of the sceneries at various cities along the river to deepen student understanding of the river ecosystem. Now let's take a look at a few concrete examples and tools at the substitution level. Please be aware that all these tools mentioned in this presentation can be used at any level of SAMR. We cannot use a tool alone to determine if a learning activity is substitution, augmentation, modification, or redefinition. The key is in the design of the learning activities. ArcGIS is an Atlas app in which the data is constantly updated. For example, when South Sudan became an independent country in Africa, the app has the new information immediately, whereas the print atlas could take up a year to update. Other substitution examples could be games. Instead of completing quizzes on paper, students can take online quizzes in the format of games, which can fall into the level of substitution or augmentation, depending on the features of the games. Some games are direct translation or paper test. Some games can record scores, provide immediate feedback, and online references, which are all enhancement of non-tech activities. Evernote is a tool that allows one to take notes and retrieve the information from any device. A teacher can set up a class folder for students to submit reports or download assignments. Evernote can not only substitute paper homework, but also allow people to collaborate. For augmentation activities, teachers can post announcements on class websites, and students can use interactive online map or database to analyze an issue. Students can also create presentation or project report using EduCreations to create multimedia presentations. Teachers can use EduCreations to create flipped classrooms to provide video lectures. This presentation can be shared online for student review. There are many other similar tools such as Explain Everything for augmentation activities. As I mentioned earlier, the Business Analyst Online, or BOA, is an app that provides facts such as population, education level, age, etc. about cities around the globe. Students will be able to learn about cities around the world through fact-finding, comparison, and contrast. Another augmentation activity is to use an app called Site by Site, in which students can visit a website or watch news together and chat about their understanding of the news, or take notes or ask questions at the same time. On the left side is the target website that everyone view together. On the right side is a website or an app that students can communicate or collaborate together. In this slide, you are seeing CNN Student News on the left side and today's meet.com, a chat application on the right side for student interaction. Now let's take a look at a few modification activities. Students can create podcasts for book reports or record a community member interview for a neighborhood project. The podcast can then be shared with the whole class for comments. The goal is to involve students in creating videos or podcasts that will require skills in scripting, storyboarding, and media production, such as using iMovie or Vimeo. Other modification activities can include website creation using Google Sites, class blog using WordPress, or social media based at class community, such as using Edmodo or Schoology. Students can collaborate on a concept map, such as using Google It or Mind Map. These are just a few tools that allow multiple users to collaborate. Now let's examine a few modification activities. Digital storytelling is an excellent way to encourage student creativity and transformative learning. The beauty of using a tablet or mobile device to create digital stories is that learners can be anywhere at any time to collect and compose the stories. Mobile devices have made it easier to collect information and compose a story. These are a few tools that are tablet-friendly, such as Story Kit for iPad, or Cast UDL Book Builder. UDL stands for Universal Design for Learning. It's a website to design accessible web content. They have a tool for creating books. Learner can add, compose, share, and read stories through the UDL website. Now let's review a few redefinition activities. Students can engage in global collaboration in which they introduce their neighborhood to each other. Here's one example of a high school student using Google Sites to introduce the demographic, culture, history, famous people, and places to visit in their neighborhood to students in Asia. The activities involve student collaboration, data collection, website production, video recording, and intensive writing for real audiences, which are their peers in other countries. At the end of the neighborhood project, students in all countries can engage in video conferencing to interact with each other and ask questions to further their understanding of the communities around the globe. Students can create digital portfolio to document their growth and invite peer feedback. This is an example from a fourth grader using Google Sites. Students can have conversation in the cloud using VoiceThread to share perspectives. Mystery Skype is also a wonderful way to engage students from two different classes to interact with each other. Educators can go to the website to request a partner teacher from other school to link with their students through Skype. The students in both classes do not know anything about each other or where they are. They have to find out where the other class is through a series of questions via a Skype conferencing. Students became excited about their class because they have to look up on the map to figure out where the other class is and ask questions that will lead to the correct answers. It's a great way to encourage full class participation. Next, I would like to present a complete example using a geography example. Students can start with using a website to look up information about a city. Next, they can use Site-by-Site or Evernote or Edmodo to take notes. Next, they can use a concept map to present their understanding of the city by listing the pros and cons of living in a city. Finally, students can use story kits or VoiceThread to write and share a story about a city and invite comments. Here's another example. Finally, here's a pedagogical wheel that put everything together. It presents activity and apps based on Bloom's taxonomy and the SAMR model. So let's take a close look at a substitution level, which is loosely at the same level of remembering or understanding Bloom's taxonomy. The emphasis are to identify and summarize or retrieve information. The activities can include searching and Googling using Google Search or course notes. At augmentation level, which is loosely related to apply in Bloom taxonomy, the emphasis is to share and construct knowledge. Google Docs or Evernote can be appropriate tools at this level of activities. At the modification level or Bloom's analyze or evaluate level, students are encouraged to examine, differentiate, or distinguish specific tasks, survey to collect data, or collaborate with peers via Edmodo are all good ways to work with students. And here are a few more apps at this level. At a redefinition level, Bloom's create level, students are encouraged to work on tasks that they can invent, design, or change. Apps such as iMovie, VoiceThread, or Prezi are all ideal tools for students who work on creative projects. Here is a wonderful website that shows another technology integration matrix. You can see there are different levels of integration from entry, adoption, adaptation, infusion to transformation, and their different tasks: active learning, collaborative learning, constructive learning, authentic learning, and goal-directed learning. So you can go to the website to look at the specific examples. And here's one more, Florida Technology Integration Matrix is also another wonderful site where they have all the examples divided by social studies, science, math, language arts, and you can look at different levels of technology integration. Finally, here are a few resources for you to look up. Tools, they might inspire your ideas for activities. At closing, I would like to say I hope the SAMR model has provided a good framework to guide your decision in designing technology-enriched opportunities to transform student learning. Have fun with it.